Lieutenant Navan Kapadia was commissioned on the 2nd of September 2000 in the 4th Battalion of the 3rd Gorkha Rifles, died while gallantly fighting Pakistan-based terrorists in the jungles of Rajwar in Kupwara district of Srinagar on the 11th of November 2000. The happiest day in the 24-year-old Mumbai-born Navang's life was when he joined the Officers Training Academy at Chennai. His parents, well-known mountaineers Harish and Geeta, encouraged him to the fullest. It was a proud moment at the passing out parade on the 2nd of September 2000 when his family and friends saw him receiving his lieutenant stars on commissioning to the prestigious 4th Battalion of the 3rd Gorkha Rifles. After a brief visit home, Navang proceeded to the regimental centre at Varanasi, from where he joined his battalion on the 29th of October 2000. The battalion was operating in the Rajwar forest in the Kupwara area of Jammu and Kashmir. The area is notorious for its broken terrain and thick undergrowth, which restricts movement and reduces visibility. They were involved in operations against foreign terrorists who had infiltrated and were in the process of establishing their bases. Navang was immediately involved in these operations, where his qualities of heart and mind, as well as his abundant courage, were a beacon to the troops under his command. On the 10th of November, the battalion received information of a large number of terrorists hiding in the notorious jungles. Navang's company had earlier operated in the vicinity and had only that day moved through the area without finding any sign of terrorists. When the platoon chanced upon the terrorist hideout, the encounter was sudden, brutal, and at close quarters. In the heavy exchange of fire, Havaldar Chitra Bahadur was severely wounded. The men went to the ground and maneuvered for tactical advantage. In such a situation, every man finds himself alone as he protects himself from hostile fire. Navang positioned himself behind a tree and was rallying the troops. Chitra Bahadur's cries of pain galvanized him into a rescue attempt where he was mortally wounded. He nevertheless continued to fire and pin down the terrorists. In a desperate attempt to escape the closing cordon, the terrorists targeted Navang and closed in on him with concentrated fire. When Navang was found, his body was facing forward, weapon in hand, with its magazine empty. Courage is a core virtue. It cannot be imbibed or force-fed. If a man does not have courage, all his other qualities will fail him in times of crisis. During training, the soldier is made to realize this quality in him. It is nurtured in a manner that the soldier understands what he is capable of, the limit of his endurance and resistance to privations, the ability to withstand danger. The institution also knows that without courage, all other qualities are as naught. As Senator John McCain put it, without courage, all virtue is fragile, admired, sought after, professed, but held cheaply and surrendered without a fight. One thing Navang never lacked was courage. The encounter resulted in the killing of two terrorists of the Al Omar Tanzim, a Pakistan-based organization, and two others were grievously wounded and likely to have died. Large quantities of arms and ammunition have been recovered. The fight lasted over 36 hours. Lieutenant Navang Kapadia died in the highest traditions of the Indian Army, living up to the ethos and standards of his battalion. Navang Harish Kapadia was born on the 15th of December 1975 in Mumbai. 3 years after his elder brother Sonam. As his surname indicates, theirs is a family of traditional cloth merchants, of a community that has a scarce presence in the defense services. From his early childhood, Navang had imbibed the best adventurous talents of his parents, both of whom have many achievements under their belt. Sonam and Navang were named after famous Sherpa mountaineers. Both are Gorkha names. Navang means leader of men, a very apt name for an able soldier. Lieutenant Navang Kapadia's sacrifice will remain a shining light to inspire future generations. He leaves behind a sorrowing family and a large circle of friends. He was cremated with military honors on Tuesday, the 14th of November 2000. Navang lies in peace, having chosen a career as he desired and dying for the country, trying to save a life in the best traditions of the Indian Army. Jai Mahakali, Ayo Gorkhali.